Hello and welcome to lesson 4 of the Articy Draft Importer for Unreal tutorial series. In lesson 3 we updated the dialog system and can now traverse through linear dialogs and end them. In this lesson we will continue to work on the dialog system so it can handle branching dialog as well. We start by adding the branch test dialog as an Articy reference to NPC 2. When we look at the dialog in Articy, we can see that we have a choice point with 2 and another with 3 options. Let's just play the level in Unreal, interact with NPC 2 and see what happens with the system we have at the moment. We actually get the corresponding numbers of buttons displayed at the choice points. Although at the moment it doesn't matter which choice we select, we always see the first option displayed on screen. And of course the buttons do not have any custom text, which makes it quite hard to make an informed choice in the first place. We will start with custom button text. For that, we need to go into the branch button blueprint. But first, I'd like to make a small adjustment I forgot when creating the button. I will change the button text to black to make it fit with the text color of the dialog box. Now we switch to the graph and create an assign branch function with 2 inputs. Flow player of type Articy flow player and branch of type Articy branch. We call this function in the demo game mode blueprint in on branches updated, right after creation of the branch button. The target comes from the Create Branch Button widget node. The reference to the flow player we can drag in from our components. And branch comes from the array element of the for each loop. Back to the assign branch function. Here we promote both parameters to variables and store them for later use. We also get a target from branch. In the Articy project, we use menu text at player choice points. This menu text I want to display as the button text, so it does not display the entire line on the button and again after the click. Where there is no menu text, I just want to display 3 dots or an arrow, as this is basically just a continue talking branch. This of course is a personal choice. You might want to go another route in your project. From the target, we cast to an Articy object with menu text. Get its menu text and promote it to a local variable by right-clicking the return value. I'll call this variable preview text. Next, we check if the text is empty, which will happen unless we are at a player choice point where menu text is used. The result we use as the condition in a branch. If it evaluates to true, meaning there is no menu text, we set the value of the preview image variable to the value we want to display for the continue talking situations. Last but not least, we use setText to assign the preview text to the button text. The branch's false option goes directly to setText, as we don't want to make further changes to the preview text variable, but use the value we set earlier with the menu text. If we play now, we see menu text used as button text, which now really lets us dive into the story and make informed decisions at the player choice points. Just one small, but still important, issue. Regardless of what choice we click, the first branch gets auto-selected all the time. but this will be fixed with one little change in the onClicked event of the branch button. Currently, it is just set to play, which always picks the first branch by default. We need to change this to play branch, with branch for the branch input. And because we stored the floor player into a variable in the assignBranch function, we can get rid of the whole casting here and just use the floor player reference. Both linear and branching dialog are displayed flawlessly in our custom dialog UI. And with that, we have arrived at the end of this lesson. We adapted our dialog system to handle branching dialog. For player choice points, we use Articy's menu text to give the player an idea in which direction the reply goes without already giving the entire dialog line away. The next lesson will bring this tutorial series to a conclusion. We will see what needs to be done to display more complex dialogs and make an improvement to the NPC interaction. See you there!